Welcome, everyone. Welcome to our online soaking service. It's a time set aside to personally encounter the presence of God. You know, join us while we listen to worship music that's surely going to bring rest to our souls and ponder the scriptures that are going to be read. They are guided scriptures for a specific purpose. And as we listen, let's draw our focus to center on the love of Jesus and position ourselves to receive his love for us. Periodically throughout the service, you'll hear scripture being read. It's a time to ask Holy Spirit to bring more understanding to these verses within your heart. Ponder the meaning of them. Ponder what God has just given you, his personal revelation for you through these scriptures. What is he saying to you? And you know, you might want to write them down so you'll be able to look over them later on and you'll be able to reflect upon them more deeper. So why don't you find a place to relax, lie down, or sit comfortably. Prepare yourself with a paper and pen. And oh, don't forget to turn off your cell phones. Yeah, I said it. Turn off your cell phones. Why don't we make this time just devoted to our King, devoted to the Almighty God, the lover of our soul, and experience the blessings that's surely going to come with it. You know, we have the privilege of coming into the presence of God. In Hebrews 4:16, it says, Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. So as we come into his presence, we come with a thankful heart, a humble attitude, a heart that's open to agree with whatever Holy Spirit says, that he brings our attention to things that we need to ask for forgiveness for. You know, those things that don't express the true character of Jesus. You know, perhaps it's an attitude that we've been having lately, or motives, actions towards self or other people. You know, when we come to the throne of grace, we come and we ask for mercy so that in our time of need, we can receive his grace. We are able to hear Father God's truth about our situation and receive his loving truth for about ourselves and his loving truth for others. Proverbs 9:10 says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and knowledge of the Holy One is understanding," which we understand the word fear as to mean to bring acknowledgement for who God is, the one who gives us life and the one who judges eternal life, to honor him, to be in awe of the greatness of who he is. To be in awe of him is the starting point for receiving God's godly wisdom for our situation in our everyday. In everyday life, we need his wisdom. And in order to receive his revelation, we have to lay down our thoughts, our way of thinking, our own way of doing things. For our God is wisdom, and he is where we find that wisdom. So why don't you with me just take this moment right now, and with an attitude of reverence and to our Almighty God, personally confess and repent. Let's just get rid of those things. Let's just get right with God. So we're just going to take a minute of silence and privately ask God, what do I need? What do I need to ask for forgiveness for? Is there anything I need to? I want to come clean. Why don't you join your hearts with me in prayer right now to say thank you, God. Thank you, for your word says that if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So we thank you for that. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. And with a thankful heart, we want to give you all the honor and the glory to your name, for you deserve it all, Lord. And we bless you, for you are our good and faithful Father. Amen. Now, just before we begin to sing our song, stir up your spirit in your heavenly language. Let's engage with Holy Spirit and worship our almighty Jesus. Amen.
Presence of the Holy God, there's new meaning now to grace. You took all my sins upon yourself. I can only stand amazed, and I cry, oh, majestic is your reign, and I am changed. The presence of a holy God, yes, I'm changed. The presence of a of your infinite might, I'm so small and frail and weak. When I see your power and wisdom, Lord, I have no words left to speak, and I cry, majestic is your reign, and I am changed in the presence of a holy God. I am changed in the presence of a holy God. Revelation 4, 8, 11, and Isaiah 6, 3. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come, you are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by you they exist. Blessing and honor and glory and power be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. Psalm 145, verse 5 tells us, I will meditate on the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works. Let us take this time to meditate upon the truth of who God is. We invite you, Holy Spirit, to open our eyes to the glory of the Father and to the beauty of the Son, our Lord Jesus, and to your presence here with us and in us today. We yield ourselves to this time where we might draw close to you and know you better. Hide us now, Lord God, in your holiness, in your sheltered place, close to your heart. Thank you.
Lord loves us, how he has we have been created by his love. In Psalm 139, it says, Lord, you know everything there is to know about me. You perceive every moment of my heart and my soul, and you understand my every thought before it even enters my mind. You are so intimately aware of me, Lord. It's just too wonderful, too deep, and too incomprehensible. You understand me. Your understanding of me brings me wonder and strength. And I thank you, God. I thank you, God, for making me so mysteriously complex. Everything you do is marvelously breathtaking. It amazes me to think about it. How truly you know me, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you that you have created me by love, in your love, through love, because you are love. I thank you. I thank you that I am wonderful in your sight. And when you look at us, you see your creation, your wonderful creation. Why don't we take this time just to ponder on how wonderful he is, that he has made us in his image, that we have been created by love. Let's rejoice in that awesome understanding.
earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you. As in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory. Because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. So I will bless you as long as I live. In your name will I lift up my hands. My soul will be satisfied as with fat and rich food, and my mouth will praise you with joyful lips. Scripture instructs us to be renewed in the spirits of your minds and to put on the new self, created after the likeness of God, in true righteousness and holiness. Let us focus on the Lord's refreshing and restoration that he offers us. Let us be renewed in the spirits of our mind as we pursue true righteousness and holiness. All these pieces broken and scattered, and mercy gathered, mended and whole, empty-handed but not forsaken. I've been set free. I've been set free. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like thank you.
thank you. We thank you, God, for your empowerment. We thank you that you have empowered us with your Holy Spirit. And so, as it says in Ephesians 3:16-19, I pray that he would unveil, that's God would unveil within you, within me, the unlimited riches of his glory and favor until supernatural strength floods our innermost being with his divine might and explosive power. Then by constantly using your faith, the love of Christ will be released deep inside you, and the resting place of his love will become the very source and root of your life. Then you will be empowered to discover what every Holy One experiences, the great magnitude of his astonishing love of Christ in all its dimensions, how deeply intimate and far-reaching is his love, how enduring, how inclusive it is, endless love, beyond measure, that transcends our understanding. This extravagant love pours into you until you are filled to overflowing with the fullness of God. Oh Lord, we position ourselves right now to receive your extravagant love more and more. Oh Lord, we ask that you pour it out into us so we can feel your manifest love within our being. And your manifest love encourages us, strengthens us, helps us to be who you have called us to be, your child. Let's focus on his extravagant love.
Heaven, pour your spirit out. Little dove, it deep.
awesome our Lord is. How awesome He is. That He just fills us with His love everlasting. That His name is not higher than any other name. And it says in Acts 4:12, salvation is found in no one else, for there is no name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. And so we continue, we bring back to You, Father, all the honor and the glory for who You are. For You are our deliverer, our Savior, our Redeemer, the lover of our soul. You are the one that empowers us. You are the one that refreshes us. You are the one that gives us life. We bless You. We honor You. And we say that You are our God and that there is no other besides You. Let's focus on how awesome God is.
Darkness, You give hope, You restore every heart that is broken. Great are You, Lord. You give life, You are love, You bring life into the darkness, You give hope, You restore every heart that is broken. Great are You, Lord. It's Your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. God. Bless you, Father. Praise you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, we thank you for being here, for your presence with us today. We have met with you in the holy place. And Lord, by your power, we are changed. Lord, seal this work upon our hearts. Seal this work upon our minds. Seal this work upon our spirits, that, Lord, we would be a testament to you and how you change our lives for the good, for your glory. Lord, we pray that you would send us from this place with new understanding of who you are, new depths of wisdom, new experience of your power. That, Lord God, knowing who we are as your children, knowing who we are as your beloved, we would be able to bring your good news to the broken. That we would be lights in this dark world, and that we would be a testament to the love that you have poured out in our hearts through the Lord Jesus Christ. There is salvation found in no other name but in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord God, we thank you that we can see your kingdom come and your will done in us and in this world. And we thank you, Father God, for this moment of heaven on earth. All praise, honor, power, and glory be unto your name, O Lord God, most high.